Taking your items. That's just spoils of war.
Of man.
Front of a warm fireplace right now.
I'd certainly kill for a nice steaming bowl of stew.
Ooh, you'd kill for stew? For once, I understand exactly what you mean.
Mila, isn't your stomach cold?
It's fine. Oh, mucus!
Looks like you're having fun over there.
I am. The human body is truly a cumbersome thing.
Anyway, who's ready to eat?
So too.
You're starting to make us look bad.
Huh?
No, just saying how reliable you are.
That wasn't too bad.
Watch a pro in action.
Sure, curve!
matter what happens, we want to protect this world.
No one can defeat my blade.
There's always room for improvement.
The spirit faith is stronger here in Azul than it is in Rashagal.
Wow, check those out!
That's something you won't see anywhere else in the world. It's one of Kanbalar's famous mountain slide cars.
What are they?
Kanbalar was built along the peaks of a mountain range. Those slide cars connect the multiple districts together.
Don't they look fun? I bet we could see forever in one of those.
How do we go about meeting the king?
I'll request a royal audience for you when I seek permission to use the wyverns. Don't get your hopes up, though. Many people come to the capital seeking an audience, so you may need to wait a bit. I suggest resting at the inn until I get back.
Right now you're trying to think of a way to do things without Jürgen's help. Just try not to make trouble for him, okay? He's a nice guy.
Thank you.
Jürgen still isn't back?
Not yet.
Elise, want to do some sightseeing?
Miss Elise, why not join Leia?
Come on, Elise. Gosh, now that Tipo's giving us the silent treatment, I guess I need to pick up the slack.
You, talk more than before? Impossible.
Meh. Hey, just because Tipo's gotten quiet doesn't mean you have to. I'd love to hear more about you, Elise, in your own words.
Shut up, Leia. You're the one holding us all back, after all.
Huh?
Elise, that was uncalled for. You should apologize.
You must have really crossed the line if Mama Mila's scolding you.
I hate Mila. And Leia, too.
Hey, where are you going?
Ouch. That stung a little. Not gonna lie.
Please, do not let it get to you.
I'm fine. We need to get Elise back.
Try to stay away from the eaves of the houses. The snow on the roofs could tumble down on you.
No reason to be alarmed. This is purely a chance encounter, nothing more.
Elise, I'm sorry about before. I can't imagine how lonely you must be without the old Tipo. I know I have a bad habit of opening my big mouth without thinking. Please forgive me.
No.
Come on, don't say that. I'll beg if I have to.
I thought you and Mila were my friends. I hate you. I hate you.
Can't you see that I'm just worried sick about you?
Liar! You don't care about me at all. I don't want to be friends anymore.
Miss Elise, everyone is being kind to you right now because you have them so concerned. You say that you feel hurt, but have you considered your own actions? Do you realize that Tipo's words were just as hurtful to Miss Leia?
I hurt Leia?
Well, hurt is a strong word, but you took the wind out of my sails, that's for sure.
I had no idea.
Why don't you try apologizing to her?
But I said such horrible things.
I am certain she will forgive you if you ask nicely. Forgiveness is the sign of a true friend.
Leia, I'm sorry. Will you forgive me?
Sure, but under one condition. From now on, I want you to tell me more about yourself using your own voice.
Huh. You're not the boss of her. You're only 3 years older.
Tipo, stop!
Elise?
Yes?
Even if it's only 3 years, I'm still older than you.
Right.
Bossy Leia, scary Leia!
There's a lesson here, child. Never take your friends for granted.
So what do we do now? Jürgen still hasn't gotten back yet.
We could just barge into the castle ourselves.
For the 100th time, let's not cause any trouble for Jürgen.
That's no good? It sounded like a good idea to me.
people, please! Stop saying mean things to Leia!
But that's on you, Elise!
No! I don't want to insult my friends!
But at the bottom of your heart, don't you want to?
No! You're wrong! Don't say things like that! Bad, Tipo, bad!
Hey, take it easy, you two!
But Tipo's been saying horrible things!
It's all right. I don't mind. Always meddling with us just because you're a few years older.
But I like it when Leia meddles.
Yep, she really does feel that way.
Oh, thanks, Elise.
Guess I'll keep right on meddling then.
Hey! Why do you always chomp my face?
As a sign of affection!
I've never seen Tipo get so close with anyone else before. So that was like a Tipo kiss.
It was? My first kiss was stolen by Jude?
Stolen? That should be my line. I can't believe I'm having this conversation with a puppet.
Don't be coy, Jude. You have to take responsibility.
Oh, Jude.
Responsibility? Responsibility for what? When did my hands get so covered with blisters and scars?
Ah, that's quite a layer of calluses forming around your knuckles.
Yeah, probably from all the people I've hit.
Didn't you want to be a doctor? That's kind of ironic. Do you regret this?
No. These calluses are proof that I'm striving to do the things I need to do.
That's the spirit! They prove you're no quitter!
A man's hands always reflect the path he's walked in life. You have the hands of a true man.
Your calluses are the coolest!
I'm going to keep fighting until I have calluses too!
Thanks. You guys are the best. Exactly is it that you absorb from foes?
I'm not really sure. It's like their energy or enthusiasm.
Is that nutritious?
Beats me. But when I'm hungry, before I know it, I'm chowing down.
You really are a peculiar creature.
What does enthusiasm taste like?
It depends on the person. For example, yours tastes like strawberries.
What? When did you absorb mine?
I don't need to absorb it to know. I can just tell.
Huh. That does sound appetizing.
Wait, what?
Thank you. Thank you.
I guess this king really does listen to his people.
The king of Arjul is well known for his charisma. It is said he unified this strife-torn country on the strength of his character alone.
A guy like that is sure to help us.
Charisma only goes so far. If his government is secretly producing children like Elise, then he must answer for it.
Thank you.
Sorry, we were getting antsy.
No, this is actually perfect timing.
Are we good to go with the Wyverns?
Yes, I got royal approval. And something incredible happened when I requested an audience for Mila.
What is it?
When I told them your names, they said His Highness was looking forward to meeting you, too. Are you all famous in Roshagal or something?
I don't think so.
Perhaps word of the tournament has reached His Highness. What a great honor for our clan. Anyway, I need to head back to Shandu to ready the Wyverns.
Quite the unexpected welcome.
It's not a trap, is it?
I have a bad feeling about this as well.
You do? It beats not getting to meet him at all.
Keeping secrets from us again?
Of course. I have to maintain my mystique for the ladies.
What does he mean?
They say men with secrets are attractive or something. I'm not exactly the right guy to ask.
Come on, let's go say hi to His Highness.
Alvin, we really need you to be straight with us.
Don't worry. I know you've put your trust in me. Considering the size of his country, Gaius's castle is actually pretty modest.
I think that's admirable.
Thank you.
halt! Citizens seeking an audience with the king are to wait in line outside the castle.
We were told the king wished an audience with us.
Is one of you Lady Mila?
That's me.
Very well. Please proceed.
What's the holdup?
I don't believe a doll is appropriate at a royal audience. I thought we might leave it here.
You sure? It's okay.
I'll hold that for you.
Now, let us meet this king.
What are you doing here?
I am Zhao the Immovable. Of the Chimeriad.
The Chimeriad?
Four warriors in personal service to the king. To think Zhao was a member all along.
It is a great honor to meet you, former Chief of Staff Ilbert.
Ah, and you are the Ebon Wing of Azul, Wingull the Nova.
You must be the King of Azul.
My name is Gaius, King of Azul. Welcome, Maxwell.
You have requested an audience with the King, have you not? Now please, state your business.
Boosters made in your country have already fallen into Rashagul hands. If a war were to break out between your nations, then the results would be catastrophic for everyone.
Oh, and you came all the way here just to tell me that in person?
Yes, Your Highness.
We're planning to destroy one of Rashagul's weapons, a really big one at that. Once that thing's gone, we know that Rashagul's king wouldn't dare declare war on you. In fact, we hope that you might, you know, help us.
Is there anything else?
Yes, there is one other matter we'd like to discuss. It is in regards to the booster laboratory within the royal hunting grounds.
Is it true you once abducted orphans for this facility, and then you performed experiments on these children?
Well, I didn't see that one coming. What does any of this have to do with you, Spirit?
I am Maxwell. It is my duty to protect both humans and spirits alike.
Really? Spirits protecting humans? Now that is quite an interesting tale.
You forsook your duty as king, and then you toyed with the lives of your own people, didn't you?
The laboratory is entirely my responsibility. It was a haven for those children. They would have died without it. You imagine it as a mad scientist's lab, but I assure you the experiments were entirely humane.
You expect us to take your word for this?
But I was...
This girl, she was that test subject?
Yes, she was.
Even in Hamil, Elise was forced to live in a tiny room. Don't you consider that...
cruel?
Well, yes.
Tell me something, boy. Have you ever considered what it takes to achieve happiness?
To achieve happiness?
Yes, to try and live a satisfying life. How do you think one can achieve that? Do you even know?
Well...
It takes freedom to make your own decisions and to form your own beliefs.
Exactly. It takes freedom.
Well, I disagree. When a man loses his way in life, the ground beneath him starts to slowly crumble until there is nothing left.
What do you mean, nothing left?
A man who cannot find his way becomes trapped. The more he struggles, the deeper he sinks into uncertainty. True happiness comes from following a noble path across an entire lifetime, without getting lost. My country does not produce failures. It is the king's duty to show his people the proper path. I must keep them from becoming completely trapped. Now, let me tell you in no uncertain terms why I've called you here. Maxwell, I know you stole the key from the laboratory in Roshagal. Now hand it over immediately.
No, I won't. The key was not meant for human hands. When faced with the power that can destroy the entire world, no human can control him or herself.
It seems as though you haven't heard a thing that I just said, Spirit.
Something about royal guidance and noble paths. I've heard it before. You humans never change. I've watched you for 2,000 years.
All right. Then why don't you just tell us where the key is?
What?
Alvin! What are you doing?
But you can't!
Alvin.
Sorry, guys. I'm just doing my job.
Alvin, who did Maxwell entrust the key to?
The handmaid Ivor. He's probably sulking back in Nia Kara as we speak.
Al, what are you doing here?
Hey, Pressa. Long time no see.
Pressa, what is it?
Ignore them. Give your report.
The Roshagal army has invaded Hamil.
What did you say?
I'm afraid the casualties are high. Those not killed were captured. They were then sent to Roshagal. We also found evidence that the power of a great spirit was used upon the village.
A great spirit? But no one has successfully summoned the four great spirits for 2 decades.
Impossible. I would have known if the four great spirits had been released. Could it be the Lance of Kresnik? Is it possible that Nautical has made a new key?
If that's the case, then we're declaring war. Send word to all the clans. I am going to crush anyone who dares to harm my people!
Well then, we will no longer have any need for the likes of you. But if His Highness were to have the Spirit Maxwell as his captive, even the unruly clans would be forced to bend their knees.
Miss Elise!
T-Bone, no!
Well, don't just stand there! Come on, run!
Capture Maxwell. Recover the test subject. Thank you.
You knew that we'd have to escape, so that's why you left Tipo with the guard.
Yes, I knew that it would end up being Mila who treated with King Gaius. And when Mila fully expresses herself, well, I figured something would happen.
I see why you were cautious.
Yep, just as predicted.
Oh, I know what that's called. That means Mila's a troublemaker.
Yeah, Mila! Did you hear the whole thing?
I can't deny the truth of your words, but there is one thing I'd like to add. By that definition, wouldn't Tipo be a troublemaker as well?
Well, I guess that's...
What? You're not gonna defend me?
I'm ready?
Okay! I'm here! I'm ready!
Ready?
I feel charitable. You may live to see another day. I assumed he had his reasons, but this time he took it too far.
Stupid traitor, let me at him!
Why would he betray us like that?
I'm afraid even I can't read his mind.
How could he do this to us? He better not show his face around us again.
Activate the 5 control stones, we may be able to unlock the gate. Pour your mana into the stones until they glow red.
Just like at Fort Gandala.
The gate will not unlock, however, unless we all activate the stones at roughly the same time.
Wait, I've never done anything like this before.
Don't worry. Just use your mana as you would when casting an art.
There's no time. We've only one chance.
Let us begin.
I'm finished too.
Same here.
I did it. Come on, come on. I'm so sick of holding everyone back. Why? Why can't I do it? Mila!
Leia, relax.
I'm not good enough for this.
Quit thinking you're inferior to anyone here.
Thanks.
You can do this. Let's continue.
Okay. Ha! Yes!
Hurry up, you two!
Gaius's henchwoman all along. Then you've been after us ever since we escaped Fenmont.
Al sold you out to His Highness way back in Nia Kara.
He was on your side the whole time.
Huh. Hardly. That man's no ally.
Huh?
I'll leave our relationship to your imagination. All I'll say is this. Al drifts from one group to the next like a ship without a compass. Trying to plot his course is impossible. Serves you right for trusting him.
It's obvious that the Lance of Kresnik is the greatest threat if war breaks out. Surely Maxwell realizes this.
Your territorial squabbles are of no interest to me. My only concern is keeping that thing out of human hands and preventing a miserable end for us all.
So high and mighty, it's time someone broke your arrogance.
Enough! You didn't become a veteran of countless battles through meaningless bloodshed. Has your youth gotten the better of you?
Don't lecture me on age, Ilbert. Your ways are old. Therefore, you falter. And then you flee.
What just happened?
A sudden burst of mana.
He has a booster.
Why? Who are you?
Ilis, Saibon Punyukaida, Chiyautai Sevon Priyande.
What? Is that Blomdao?
Suhun Susu Maxwell. Wizun Kityodo.
I warned you, he's quite strong like this. Can't understand a word he's saying, though. You'll understand. Once we're all finished with you, then you'll hear it.
Open the covenant of darkness!
Look out! Dance, I have your back.
Locked on target! Charge complete! Fire!
It's good!
I'll cover you.
Dragon Man Claw!
Don't worry! Alright!
Dragon Man Claw!
You ready?
Okay!
Let's go, Roger.
Where are you?
And a rock was in time.
hair completely changed.
And his speech, too.
Has mana dramatically increased. There can be only one reason, a booster.
That wasn't too bad.
Excellent.
I feel much stronger.
You're really coming into your own.
Never stop improving.
All right.
What now?
Still want to play, do you?
Wait!
Don't try to stop me.
No, look!
I suppose our time is up.
Running away again, Ilbert? It's because you ran last time that King Noctigal ended up the way he did.
I'm surprised that you would care. The people of that village treated you horribly.
It's true that we were bullied a lot.
But there was a man who gave us fruit, and a woman who put a blanket over me so I wouldn't get cold. They didn't deserve to have horrible things happen to them.
I see.
And having a great spirit running wild would be so scary.
It was the Rashagal army that attacked, right? Why would they do that?
I don't know. It seems we'll have to head to Rashagal to find out. And more importantly, to ensure the tragedy of Hamil is not repeated.
Yes.
fulfill my mission, no matter what happens.
I'm right there with you. Zhao is one of King Gaius's henchmen.
One of four. They're called the Chimeriad, because each member embodies a different weapon of the Chimera. Wings, horn, stinger, and fangs. I've heard rumors about them.
Like what?
It isn't public knowledge, but 2 years ago, hostilities broke out on Shrade Island. Rashagal sent 120 elite soldiers, but the rumors say they were wiped out by four enemy agents.
Four people defeated 120 soldiers?
Sounds like we shouldn't wake the beast.
Total annihilation.
Too bad.
Huh? I'm ready! Okay!
Focus!
Here you go!
That's one!
Okay!
It's not working?
Face total annihilation. Of man.
There's always room for improvement. Of the clan that used to rule Azul.
Do you speak it?
Not really, but I can understand it to some degree.
But what made him abruptly start speaking like that?
It appeared to be some sort of battlefield transformation. A side effect of his booster, perhaps.
Does that mean I'll start speaking some weird language too?
Then you wouldn't be able to talk to anyone.
Relax, that won't happen. His booster is totally different from Tipo. And if you did start speaking some weird language, I would totally learn it so we could still talk. Thank you.
Are you good with languages, though?
Side the point.
Huh?
Please.
You get along so well!
Altercation in the capital may have preceded us.
How is your audience with the king?
I'm sorry, we'll have to talk later. Can we depart right away?
Well, I guess that's possible. You in some kind of hurry?
Yeah! The king's men are hot on her!
No need to rush off.
Alvin?
They're on a wild goose chase in the mountains right about now.
You threw them off our scent? Is this some kind of peace offering?
What? It's only natural I helped you. We're friends, aren't we? Come on, you don't believe me? I know you've put your trust in me before. Would it kill you to give me another shot?
I guess not.
Attaboy.
Welcome back. I'm glad that you're safe.
Thanks. You almost sound sincere.
If nothing else, it seems that Alvin has bought us some time.
I'd ask what's going on, but I don't think I want to know. You people sure have a lot of drama in your lives. I'll be in front of the Wyverns. Come see me when you're ready to fly.
It's finally time.
We'll saddle up as soon as we're ready.
Right.
Person to Rowan and Mila?
Yeah, I did.
Well, your acquaintances are my acquaintances. Hook a girl up!
Here she goes. Fine, fine. Let's head to Shandu.
I am beat. Come on, let's get a room for the night.
Are you okay? You look pale.
I'm fine. I just keep thinking about Hamil.
What happened there isn't your fault. You should try forgetting about it. I guess that's easier said than done. Maybe it would help to go see Hamil for ourselves. Wait, hold up.
Still having doubts about me, huh? It looks like you're not the only one. Fine, fine. Remember the first time the three of us went to Niakara, and I went off by myself?
The time that I came out of my shrine and Jude was the only one there?
That's the one. I was off meeting with Wingle.
So you had a secret arrangement with them, to hand Mila over if she became a problem.
How could you? Stabbing Mila and Jude in the back like that?
Hold it. Yeah, I was working a few different angles back then, but this time I was just using that to our advantage. You know, the only reason we were given permission to use the Wyverns is because I arranged that with them ahead of time.
Wait, so when you betrayed us in front of Gaius...
Yep. If I hadn't pretended to betray you there, they never would have let us ride the Wyverns. That's why I lied and told them you ran in the opposite direction of Xiandu.
I want to believe you, but I can't. Not yet.
That reminds me. That Pressa woman we met at Kijara Seafalls, it seemed like you already knew her.
What do you want to know?
Who is she, really? How can we trust you if you keep hiding information from us?
Hey, all right, calm down. No need to get snappy.
Do you even know what you're putting us through?
I met her when I was working for Rashagal's intelligence service. At the time, she was an Azul secret agent working undercover in Fenmont.
And?
After that, we became more personally involved. You probably don't want to know the specifics.
Okay, I believe you, but I still don't trust you.
You're so cute when you're upset.
Stop that. I'm still angry at you.
All right, all right.
Alvin, can I ask you one last thing?
Of course.
Tell us why you're helping us. What's in it for you?
You're asking that now? Because I love the hell out of you guys, of course.
More lies!
How could you even think that? I'm hurt.
Hello, Jude. Good to see you again. Hi, I'm Carla Outway.
I'm Leia. Leia Rolando.
Hey, I recognize you. I've seen you here in the city before, haven't I?
Name's Alvin. I do get around. It's possible you've seen me before. What about yourself? You must be from out of town if you're staying at the inn.
That's right. I'm from Canbalar. I haven't been home in a long time, though.
Oh, we've been there. Not the most pleasant of trips.
I'm sorry to hear that. Were you able to meet with King Gaius?
We did. He's a stern man, but clearly very dedicated to his people. In a way, he was kind of amazing.
Kind of amazing, yeah, but super scary. Why can't he just be nice to people?
King Gaius didn't always used to be that way. Do you know about the Battle of Fezabel?
Well...
It was a battle fought on the Fezabel outback 20 years ago between Roshagal and Azul. The battle only ended due to a giant tsunami. No one's sure why it appeared when it did. It ended up causing dramatic changes to the region's spirit climb. That's how it became Fezabel Marsh, with all its twisted marsh flows.
Oh, right, right! That Battle of Fezabel! Yup, it's all coming back to me.
Wow, you actually remember? I'm kind of shocked.
You don't need to be embarrassed if you don't know. It's never too late to learn.
Oh, Carla, you're so nice! You could learn a lot from her, Jude.
Uh-huh.
During that battle, Gaius led a battalion of Longdao soldiers, even though he was a member of a different tribe himself. At just 20 years old, he led his troops to victory against an entire regiment of the Roshagal army. He was also the first to sense the oncoming arrival of the giant tsunami. He advised the Longdao chief to retreat, but the chief couldn't bring himself to give the order. The tsunami ended up swallowing both armies and wiped out Gaius's entire battalion.
So that's how he became the ornery fellow we all know and love. Gotta hand it to him, though. It is true that most folk want a strong leader to guide them. And he's certainly won the trust of his people.
Gosh, Carla, you really do know all about history.
Well, at least when it comes to King Gaius.
Is there a reason for that?
There just might be. See you later, everyone.
What do you think she meant by that?
I wonder.
Plenty of heat between Carla and Gaius, huh?
You make it sound so illicit.
And poor sweet Jude's left out in the cold.
Come on, you know that's not why I'm looking for Carla.
Bet she's waiting in Shandu.
You think I don't know that?
I'm surprised to see you here. What can I do for you today?
Carla, if you don't mind us asking, what's your relation to King Gaius?
Now, I sure wasn't expecting that.
Come on! I bet it's a great story!
I appreciate your interest, but I get the sense that Jude isn't asking out of idle curiosity. Around the time of the Battle of Fezabel, I was betrothed to a man from the Longdao tribe. It was an arranged marriage, but nevertheless, we fell in love with each other at first sight. Naturally, my betrothed had to go to war with the rest of his tribe, but he never came back.
Because of the tsunami?
No.
It wasn't Gaius, was it?
My betrothed was one of the Longdao chief's aides. He wanted to make a name for himself before we got married. He must have thought that's what I wanted. So when Gaius told the Longdao chief about the incoming tsunami, my betrothed told the chief that Gaius was out of his mind and swore that a retreat wouldn't be necessary.
And Gaius went after him for that?
The few people who survived the tsunami said that my betrothed was still alive after it had passed, and that Gaius was with him.
I can't believe it.
All I know for sure is that he never came back. They never even found his body. I don't know for sure if Gaius did something to him. When I asked the king about it, he refused to answer. After the battle, my father died from an illness, and I never saw my brother Erston again. I've been alone ever since.
After all that, you'd be nuts not to hate the guy.
Come on, Alvin.
And I bet your hatred for King Gaius is pretty much the only thing keeping you going at this point.
You may be right about that.
I'm sorry.
Now, it's time for me to leave Xiandu for a while.
Where are you going?
Somewhere in Azul. See you all around.
Everyone's gone.
And now more of my memories are gone with them.
But they weren't very good memories, were they?
No, but they're still better than having nothing at all. Hey, come on. The fruit trees are still here. The mountains are still here.
I don't have memories of fruit.
I do. I remember having fruit curry for dinner once a week.
Oh, yeah. The mayor always put apples in it. It was her favorite thing to make. Although, it was a little too sweet for me. Hey, wait a minute. Tipo can talk about things that Elise isn't even consciously aware of?
I guess so.
Then maybe Tipo can help you remember the things you've forgotten. Didn't you say Xiandu looked familiar? If we use Tipo there, maybe you can remember something.
That's very perceptive.
If this works, Elise may even be able to learn something about her parents.
That would be great!
That's a really smart idea, especially coming from you, Leia.
Why, thank... Hey!
Well, it's good to see Elise excited again. Well done.
In Leia's case, I think that was probably half inspiration and half blind luck.